Ho Chi Minh City. It is such an honor to be here with all of you today and to participate in this wonderful competition. Today, I would like to share some of my suggestions with all of you about how to encourage recycling. First, we need to know exactly what is recycling. Recycling is a process of taking waste materials and turning them into new usable objects. You see, in everyday action in our life, trash, either directly or indirectly, is almost always involved. Therefore, it is becoming a global problem. In two of the major cities in Vietnam, Hanoi and Ho Chi Minh City, more than 30,000 tons of trash is dumped out yearly. About 50 to 70% of them is expected to be recycled. However, in reality, only 10% of it is recycled. Waste is nowadays becoming a very valuable resource. But how could we fully exploit this source then? First, governments need... Here's some of my solutions on hand. First, governments need to invest more in building more waste plants and recycling centers. Second, we need to raise more awareness in teaching younger generations about recycling. Third, we need to create opportunities for citizens to change their habits. And finally, after all that, we should have strict fines and reinforce more rules so that people can remember. Governments should invest more in waste plants and recycling centers. To get raw materials to fuel work in these waste plants, that is, sort of trash, we need to first understand why it's so hard to get people to sort out the trash in Vietnam. There are two reasons. First, they might not know the consequences if they don't recycle and they just dump trash altogether. Or they may know, however, their old habits of dumping things altogether is too hard to drop. For example, you see, if we dump organic waste with nylon bags needs about 500 years to decompose completely. And during that 5 centuries, many future generations of ours need to eat food and drink water contaminated with the chemicals from our dump today. Imagine the consequences that it might go. However, if just a simple act of sorting out the trash, organic waste could be used as compost, and plastic items could be melted down and made into new plastic objects. Next, to make people aware of this new idea, we should use mass media such as newspapers, TVs, and radios. Also, we could have posters, flyers, and billboards talking to people about the importance of recycling and why we should recycle. Also, we should teach younger children at an early age about recycling. We should teach them to recycle and how to sort out the trash. These could be fun, but also educational activities too. After we have begun to have some awareness, we need to provide opportunities for them to change their habits. For example, in some neighborhoods and apartments, governments should give them 3-chamber trash cans. There is a trash can with 3 different chambers so that people can dump different sizes of trash. Also, in some neighborhoods, we should, where people could agree to a commitment of sorting out the trash. If they agree, then we should provide them with trash can for each household, and at a scheduled time every day, their trash could be picked up directly at home. Afterwards, we need to have stricter fines and reinforceable rules. Volunteers and guards could be patrolling the streets to search for people and give them fines so that people could remember about doing it. We need to cooperate with citizens, synchronize and check regularly, and also states need to pursue this for a long time so that we can succeed. Thank you very much for listening.
Hello, Rachel. Yes,
yeah.
I like your presentation so much. But,
thank you very much.
I want to know one thing.
Yes.
Have you ever tried to recycle something?
Well, yeah.
If so, yes. Can you describe what is it and how do we?
It's recycling to a high priority. We really sort out the trash, and we did dump it into different waste bins at our apartment. They already gave that. And also, in my school, we also teach students about how to sort out the trash and how to recycle. And there's some fun activities where students make posters and flyers about that. And I also use some plastic bottles and use materials to make toys. Therefore, we can save money on toys and we still have some really cute stuff.